Respectful development for all generations. DonlandGold.com.
We are a key part of the Alaskan economy and culture and politics. And so we have to be involved and continue to be involved in order to protect our way of life and to have a say in decisions that go on in Alaska and in the nation.
My hopes and dreams for the future are that what we have going now will continue, so that we don't lose any of our language and culture. It is our identity, you know? It is who we are.
For nearly 70 years, MTA has been connecting Alaskans. We all live here and are invested in the communities we serve.
A lot of snow there.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
We've built our network to evolve and power new solutions. Inspired by our members.
I think everything looks good.
Yeah, looks perfect.
So that you can connect to whatever it is that drives you. MTA, life, technology, together.
Woo! 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 different from the other air carriers in Alaska because we have a long tradition of operating in Alaska, the largest all-cargo airline for 66 years now.
We supply everything that you can think of going out from construction to medicine to food to beverages. NAC is truly the lifeline to rural Alaska.
It is really easy to ship a package on Northern Air Cargo. You arrive at our facility here at the airport, our cargo service agents will meet you at your vehicle, help unload your freight, weigh it for you, help you process the paperwork, take it out to rural Alaska for your needs. Living in rural Alaska and operating a business there is arguably more challenging than in many parts of our country. If we can help them be successful, then we've considered it a job well done.
NAC's huge in our preparation, you know. I mean, we stage parts at the main hubs throughout the race. Every checkpoint on the trail is off the road system, so you're relying on air support to be able to get that stuff, and it's huge having NAC deliver the goods. They're a huge part to our success for sure.
Who you work with really makes the job, makes the whole entire process enjoyable. And so I want to work here because I like the people.
You know, something that makes Estelle pretty special is the caliber of people.
The team is fantastic and they're all good hard workers. They've got an excellent attitude.
We have a wonderful community out here. Many of them are local. A lot of us are from the Mat-Su Valley here in Wasilla, myself, born and raised in Alaska.
We really pride ourselves to not only hire Alaskan, but to buy Alaskan. Some of the contractors we use, Soloy Helicopters, Yakuskakon, these outfits have been involved in Alaska for decades, working on other minerals projects. They know the terrain, how to operate in these environments.
Jobs like this are really important to be here in Alaska because there's room for growth. The economic impact that these projects have potential to bring is huge.
In order to be successful and even to have achieved what we have so far, it's important to be engaged and work with all of our stakeholders. We support communities through sponsorships and donations, things like youth sports programs, Alaska Resource Education Foundation, Kenai River Sports Association, just iconic Alaskan events, Iditarod, the Iron Dog, the Squint and a Fly-In. You know, the examples are just numerous.
We're committed to creating a safe and environmentally responsible future mining operation that provides opportunities for all Alaskans.
The 2023 Iron Dog Raffle is bigger than ever. Over $100,000 in prizes. A Ram Bighorn from Anchorage Chrysler Dodge. A Royal Cargo 16-foot enclosed trailer courtesy of Big Bubba's Trailers. A Polaris 850 Chaos from Hatcher Pass Polaris. Four round-trip tickets from Alaska Airlines and $10,000 cash. And other prizes from these great sponsors. Buy yours now. Purchase online at irondog.org or call 563-4414.
You guys ready to hit the trail?
Right on.
Let's go.
We'll be right back.
CBC is a family-owned, locally grown Powersport dealership in Wasilla and Eagle River, Alaska. We have lived our whole lives here and have a passion for exploring the great outdoors of Alaska and serving our community. We sell Powersport vehicles that will get you out into Alaska's great outdoors, including Ski-Doo and Lynx snow machines, Kawasaki ATVs, side-by-sides, motorcycles, and jet skis, Sea-Doo personal watercraft, Can-Am ATVs and side-by-sides, and Fat Truck. Team CC carries Marlin truck decks and Halcan trailers to haul your power sports.
Team CC's service department and master technicians are ready to repair and tune your vehicle. Our parts department carries OEM and aftermarket parts, accessories, and riding gear, including Fly, Climb, and Fox shocks. Team CC is a Fox shocks distributor in Alaska, an authorized service and warranty center. We have a dyno machine to fine-tune your shocks to all brands, dialing in the perfect ride.
Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and at our website, teamcc.com. Team CC, Alaska grown and family owned. Become a CC rider today.
For 45 years, Tote has called on the Port of Alaska. Through good times and challenges, calm seas and extreme weather, we have been driven by an unwavering commitment to deliver for Alaskans and the last frontier. And through the dedicated support of all who make it happen, our journey with Alaska will continue for generations to come. Tote is proud to be a part of Alaska.
All right, bills are paid. Welcome to the wrench day here in Nome, Alaska. The weather is sideways outside. We got a blizzard running in here, and it's supposed to be keeping going until early Thursday. So we're pretty excited to spend the next couple days here with you as we get inspections underway and wrenching underway. We got a couple people down there looking around and figuring out what's happening today. Inspections are supposed to kick off around 8:30, so we got about 14 minutes till we start seeing some good inspection time coming in. Keep your eyes open. Feel free to let us know who you are cheering for in the chat. That chat does archive, so your racers will be able to go back later and see all the great stuff you said for them and about them. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. Special thanks to Tote for making this possible this year. They sponsored the students from South Anchorage High School to make the trek up here and to Big Lake to get the start, the Nome Garage, and the finish right into your homes. Enjoy the show. Looks like Tyson's got a couple teams getting ready to start inspecting down there. We'll get some cameras down there to get a little bit of a closer view. Should be a good time for those of you new to the Iron Dog. Each team gets 15 minutes to inspect their vehicles where they can actually touch them, move them, measure, manipulate, make a list of what they need to work on during their wrench time. So we'll see a little bit of that kind of roll through. And then they will get their wrench time scheduled. And during that time they are on the clock, it counts against their trail time. So sit back and enjoy. Hey, Connie, to answer that question, I'm sure they do have a schedule lined out. Tyson's probably got things lined out really well. We don't have that schedule up here. I can get someone down there to see if we can get a hold of it, and we'll let you know. Thank you. All right, official word. There is not a schedule for inspections today. As they come in and as Tyson is available or other officials are available, they will make sure they're there to make sure everything goes clean on their inspection. So, no, I cannot tell you when someone is going. So you have to stay tuned the entire time.
2.5 minute refresh this year. So I'm gonna change all the batteries for your fire. Yeah, it's much better. There's still a couple that are intermittent that we're working on, but I think we got it figured out. Yeah, how's things going on your end? Yeah, right on. You guys are doing a nice job.
They made it easy this year.
Yeah. Much, yeah. What's that?
90 days.
Yeah, excellent. That's good.
What's the game plan today?
Today? Well, the teams will do
the rest of the morning at least.
Yeah, the teams will probably all do their inspections. Yeah. We're going to try to. A lot of them, I think a lot of them, we're going to show up around 10.
Okay.
So, and then if teams don't have a lot to do, they may work
just
before the banquet. Yeah.
Well,
cool. So, I mean.
Crank it out. How does that work? Can you do an inspection if you can wrench whatever? Or do you have
you have to schedule it with the marshals.
Yeah.
But, like these guys, Cody and Brett probably have, what do you think? 10 minutes? 6
That's
minutes?
Work. He's just going to polish the cowling and get back out there.
My cowling's not getting polished. So my bumper's pushed. Brett won't let me do it. I gotta live with that to the finish line. Yeah, we got pretty minimal.
Yeah.
Are you guys gonna try and wrench like before like noon or whatever?
Probably around the noon, afternoon maybe. Go get breakfast and round up a couple pieces.
Thank you.
betcha.
So, does the bank do it for 1 to 3?
I think so.
Okay, that's what I thought. It's usually at 6. Well, I might run and grab a quick bite to eat before I tear into this. And, of course, TSA. They took my power screwdriver and my SIPs. Over 7 inches, I guess, is the rule now. So, that kind of sucks.
Ryan's the only one in this front four.
Yeah.
Coffee shop is at a breakfast.
Craftsman, you turn it and just know that it stops. Dumb.
You didn't have a check bag, huh?
Nope. I just brought a. Just a carry on. 7. Thank you.
final voltmeter?
I'm just going to swap the battery.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I can sit there pretty good, but I haven't worked since Big Lake, so I made it to the auto. So, swap the battery, it works right on, it does it, carry on.
Yeah, is this your aux light?
Yeah, aux light. GPS.
That sucks.
Yeah.
I had my aux light go out once. Something went through the windshield and broke it. So I had no light, so I was just chasing the whole way, you know?
Yeah. Well, I'm behind Chad anyway, so it's not... Can't see back there anyway, so
yeah.
I just closed my eyes the whole time.
Watching helmets?
Yeah. It's on that other paper, which I think I have in here. Right. I think it's on this. One to three? What the hell? Does anybody know it's at one?
Nobody scheduled actual work sessions.
Yes.
I imagine most of them will be after the banquet.
Thank you.
have their number?
They wrench like four, I think, even worse, so I would have to tell
do you.
Do
you have their number? Or do you
I do not have it.
All right, folks, things have slowed down just a little bit. We probably got some folks out there getting some coffee and some breakfast. It was a long night, and the weather's a little bit choppy outside, so they'll be wandering in slowly as they get through the day, get inspections done. Remember to join us for the Gnome Banquet later today. I believe that's from 1 to 3. There'll be a stream link on irondog.org. Get a look at some of the prizes those folks get for getting up here first, getting up here last, and everything in between. We'll be streaming that live to you, and then we'll be back to the garage after the banquet for wrench time. We'll see if we get anyone wrenching in here before that. We still got quite a few inspections to do. They got to get parts lined up and everything else. It's going to be a little bit tough. If parts aren't already up here, they're going to be scrounging around town because I don't know if we're going to get a plane up here. So sit back, relax, enjoy. Thank you to all the sponsors, as you see clipping across the screen over the next few minutes. Thanks to Tote for making this happen for us.
Thank you.
foot is at 1, yeah.
Thank you. torsions. Change torsions. Thank you.
Okay.
What?
It's live.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, pretty awesome.
Yeah, very cool.
So, my thought is, we'll fire these up this afternoon, we'll test them all. But in the meantime, I'm going to get all the batteries done and just go run a zip tie through every one, so that's all done.
Perfect.
So then I
what
test
can we
them.
Help with?
Right now, I'm just actually, what would help is old zip ties are still on the sleds, and I have new ones if you want to run zip ties through.
You want to make cut the old ones? Or they
the old ones are already cut.
Okay.
Yeah.
I did contingent stuff.
Yeah, Kent's working on those right now.
I think we just needed the four. That's all I want to do.
Okay.
The ones that are in there.
Mm-hmm.
And I got one other one. It got sent to me via Barry. Yeah, right.
Oh, shoot. Okay.
So it's a fastest Norvik to COTS.
Okay. Yeah, we'll have to make sure we have it.
But the Norvik to COTS doesn't work because we came
the other way.
Norvik.
Yeah, we went the other way.
Yeah.
So if they want COTS to Norvik, we can figure that one out.
Thank you.
Cots to Nor?
Norvik.
Cots to Norvik.
To Norvik.
Okay.
We need that. So he was the fastest split time.
Okay.
I don't know.
Thank you.
busy and weather are a lot better, that's for sure.
Can you help Mike? It doesn't matter. Oh shit.
Yeah, go to your stats page. And that's where we'll show. Mike's running zip ties, so.
Yeah, that's.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, they were working. Here you go, Mike. And
that neat?
Exactly how many is that?
Three. Every sled has got a tie on it.
Awesome, thank you.
We have extra
zip ties?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a pack of them.
Because I can foresee this happening when they work on their sleds. They can fall out.
Yeah. Yeah, I got a couple packages.
So just FYI.
I can see they can
fall out. Yeah, for sure. And then, so working on a private page. Working on a page for 77. Put Chris on that too, so at least the families can follow. Roger always asked me to turn.
Chris Roger home with them.
Okay. So.
We're not leaving today.
No.
Because I'm not gonna left.
No.
You might be tough, Roger, but I didn't know you were stupid too.
Oh, but I'm not left.
Yeah. Oh, he wants to.
Yeah.
our GPSs or tonight or at the banquet? We don't have the bases, but we'll get you at least the GPS, get that out of the way.
Yeah, that'd be great. Appreciate it.
It takes about 4 days to get it in and about
yesterday, like, they're all frozen. I'm like,
what's the website to follow the ambassadors back?
I don't have a URL yet, but I'll get you.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
Yep.
Doing?
Doing good. How are you?
Good.
This is you right here.
Huh? Oh.
We got fresh batteries.
I got lost.
No shit. Okay.
Huh?
Okay, we can take a look at it.
You know, the tie strap busted.
Oh, okay.
It's so good.
Thank you.
anyone take your picture doing hard work?
No.
Because I will. Show me something good. Here. Are you changing the batteries in all those?
In all of them.
Dang.
Because we have 2.5 minute tracking this year. So.
This is a great picture. If I still have your number, I'll send it to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hey, Walker. Come on, we're on the date.
Thank you.
good?
Yep.
Good job.
Thank you. We'll take them outside here after the banquet, fire them all up, make sure they're talking, and then come out all this afternoon. Maybe.
Yeah. I mean, we can do it later tonight once we decide what we're doing. We might have all day tomorrow.
All right. Yeah, and that's the key thing is we just don't. They'll sit here and look for a signal. You know. So. Guys.
Or give us something to do tomorrow. Yep. Find me enough money, I can go buy me a one-way ticket someplace warm. I think I got four. No, I only paid for three tracks.
They were all like,
got the list of the order in the known? Who's the team with the fastest time with the rookie? Barber's not a rookie.
This is what we have so far.
I don't know why I would be fine.
Here, I'll just send it to you.
It's like the fifth one down, seventh.
Fastest
northbound team.
maybe we should just have somebody. If you're done, are you done here?
Pretty much.
Maybe we should just go to the convention center where it's quieter.
Yeah. Let me make a quick phone call.
Okay.
Yeah, we have an Excel that's sorted. That'll make it easier, or if you just want to work up here, whatever you want.
You had to put batteries in the spot units?
We did.
Today? I mean, like.
We already did.
Oh, you have to do it every.
No, because we enhanced the ping this year from 5 minutes to 2.5.
Oh, so it wears it down, so you got to redo it.
Well, we don't know, so yeah, we just right. Precaution.
Yeah, right.
Last thing I want is Mark to come.
Because I got
these fucking guys aren't pinging. What's fucking wrong?
Because I
you
got
guys?
One in my semi that's the same thing as this.
Yeah.
And I have it on a 2-minute ping.
Oh.
It'll last a week. Prudhoe and back. So.
Is it in the cab?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't know.
Yeah, I'm with you.
So.
No, I agree.
We just said we're changing them all.
Yeah, I got the same one.
Because we want to make sure that 16 stays in front of 11.
Yeah, and then when it's not moving right here, it shuts itself down.
We haven't activated them yet.
So.
They're all in here.
Stripped them little fuckers out.
They're gone. They're gone. I'll
whoop this motherfucker's ass someday when I get big enough.
Motherfucker, I'm half your age and twice your size.
Twice is stupid.
Thanks for letting us know.
When he starts singing.
Thank you. same place.
Yeah. I'll go through and okay. I'll lay them out and take a picture. Okay. We got to get over to the mini, but I'm just going to hang on to these. Okay. So, thank you. I appreciate it very much.
How many years have you been doing this now?
12, so this is my 11th year.
Yeah,
no problem.
Still enjoying it?
Yeah, of course. It's a
my
lot of fun.
Jim.
Jim.
When you put it on,
that's it.
Yeah. Everything is going very well. I think there are a lot of perspectives and a lot of the subject.
One thing we discussed a lot is having little brackets, but we'll remove brackets and give it to you guys. Do you usually get 100% return on the brackets?
No, I guess it's probably more like 50%, but we do reuse them because they're harder and harder to come out.
We'll definitely pull them up again.
That'd be fantastic.
They're kind of tedious.
Yes.
Cool. I see the tractors have all been moved on the slits.
I changed all the batteries just to
make sure they're fresh
Are they rechargeable or is it?
No, they're
the battery.
Like one of those little batteries?
2.3.
Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, AAA.
AAA.
Yeah, so I've changed them all this morning. After we acquired them, the satellite is there for
a so you can like sign them to the
operation? Yeah. And then once they start talking, then I can bring them into the
Well, no, it's just that faster movement into covering it and stuff.
folks. Hope everyone's having a good time out there. We're going to let this run until about noon, and then this stream is going to turn off. And then at 1 o'clock, the banquet stream will be up. Banquet's from 1 to 3 today, so we'll be down at the halfway at the Nome Mini Convention Center. And that will stream from 1 to 3. You can get that link on irondog.org. And then after the banquet at 4 o'clock, there will be a new link for the new garage feed. Starting at 4 o'clock this afternoon. That's when wrenching is going to commence. If there are any more inspections, they'll take place at that point, but then wrenching is going to commence. It's going to get loud in here. So keep watching. We've got about 28 minutes of content left. At some point, we'll pay some bills, and there'll be some commercials. And then we'll shut this one down, and you'll be able to pick it back up at the banquet hall at 1 o'clock. Thank you. Bye-bye now.
Probably. I think, yeah, only a couple people have been on the time. What's funny is I was going to text people that was here that I didn't have the number.
No, yeah, Chris and Mike are going to help us.
Okay. Just make sure you've got everything you need. Put the solid ones in the side.
Thank you.
One more time. It was about to go.
They send up fucking regular green and then a goddamn like.
What was the final verdict over there?
We're gonna probably split the difference into five. Like, okay. We've never done more. And we're gonna reiterate it at the driver's meeting, you know, like.
We have one fucking 13.
We'll settle with five. That's fine. We talked about that too originally. Like, well, we'd be fine with five.
I mean,
if you're gonna gain anything out of it, it could possibly be 5 minutes. You know? But if it was a blatant, like, we knew it, you know,
well,
then
the
that's what took me.
The reason why like, more than me is that you guys didn't want to go late. You guys got
it. He said Doug changed it. That was the one who made that rule.
You know what happened? What's crazy? Last year, that told me Doug made some call. And now this year, we're getting word that Doug was going to do this weekend. It's like, I feel like Doug would just be a race marshal because he just like does shit on his own. But anyway, it's like
10 and 10. 13 and 13. Chris has got wrench for those chain case.
He's trying to get it. He needs to get one more right now. After.
What's that?
They roll it out right now.
I think they're going right now.
Drop a mixtape. Mic check. For this or
oh, can you go grab my belt? I don't have any coats.
Yeah. Thank you. got one right there on my bumper.
We shouldn't need another one. This got something. This is stock something. This is last year's. I don't know where that came from. We put two belts in my dad's coat and he brought it.
Yeah, perfect. This was in my bag. Yeah, we don't want that. Hey.
All right, folks, we got to shut this one down so that it archives and we don't use any off the front end. We're going to break down and head over to the Mini Convention Center for the banquet. You'll be able to find that link at irondog.org. That's irondog.org. And then we'll be back for wrenching and inspections at 4 o'clock. Goodbye.